Hello friends, so today we're going to discuss the problem A from the latest Code Forces RAF round 1. So problem is box is full. So you can read this problem statement, but in simple terms it states that you are given a box at some coordinate x1, y1 and you have to take this box to x2, y2. Now you cannot take this box directly, but a mouse is pulling this block. So now the mouse is connected to this box using a length of like a rod, or like you can assume a string of length 1. Okay, so as you can see, if the box is at this coordinate, the mouse can be at this coordinate, this coordinates, and so on. And thus, like the mouse can also be at this coordinate. And thus, the mouse has to take this box to this point. So now how the mouse can take, and the mouse can move every second, like the mouse can move from every one block to another point in 1 second. So how much time it will take? And that's the whole question. Now, you can draw out this question using these two examples, it will become more clear. Okay, so I will like use these two examples only. Okay, or I will just draw a very simple thing. Let's assume that there is one point at this is the blocks at this point. And the question also gives that the mouse can be at any position. But see, if the starting position of the box is fixed, the box should be taken from this coordinate to this coordinate. And thus, the mouse can be anywhere in the radius of one in the box, like around the box. I hope you get the point. So the thing here is the mouse can be at this point above, side, this side, or that, like these positions can be the mouse. And now let's assume that the position at which my box should be is in the same horizontal line, but at this position. So now the mouse can easily do here is like the mouse can be on one position ahead of this, and you can easily drag this box. So the mouse can be at this position. After 1 second, the mouse will be one step ahead and the box will be at this. So same, the distance between these two points is just the answer, because the mouse will have to move till this point. Okay, that's when the box will come at this point. The box will come like it will drag by one meter, as you can assume 1 meter or 1 point by every second, and then it will reach to this point. Same, it can be extrapolated to vertical distance. So if there is no like change in vertical or horizontal direction in both the time, like as you can see, in one time only you have to do only vertical movement or horizontal movement, then the answer is just the difference between like the initial position and the final position. But as you can see in the example, there is one example in which it is 1 1 and 2 2, in which you can draw it out and you can assume that this is 1 1 1 1 and this is 2 2. So now how the mouse can reach that point, they are telling that as you can see in the second test case, Babbitt can start at the point 2 1 and pulls the box, like because he at this point he can start at 2 1, so this is 1 2, so he can start at this point, and as you can see the box is at this point. Then what he'll do, he will pull the box to 2 1 and while moving to 3 1. So as you can see that he can move to 3 1, and when he moves to 3 1, the box will pull at this position. Okay, then he moves to 3 2. So then he moves to 3 2, this position. As you can see, he has this position. So then this is 3 2. And then to 2 2. And then to 2 2. So it is taking him 2 seconds to turn his direction. As you can see, his direction is this. Then it taken 1 second to this and then 1 second to this. So in 2 seconds, he changes direction. And then it's like again, he is on this position and he wants to go to this position, and he has the position of this and the boxes are at this position, and you can assume that this is the distance, so he has to travel this point, this distance. So the main crux of this problem is, if there is some difference between the height, like vertical and horizontal both, then he can first move to any vertical or horizontal position, whatever he wants, and then it takes 2 seconds to turn. And then he can do the same. So as you can see, if there is no turning, as you can see in this, there is one turning chance. If there is no turning, he has to only move the horizontal or vertical, then the answer is just the difference between these two points. But if there is some turning, then the answer is just difference between these two points plus 2 seconds, because it takes 2 seconds to turn. And that's the whole logic for this problem. That's it. So as you can see, if A is equal to C, which means that A is equal to C or B equal to D means that it is on the same horizontal level or vertical level. Okay, like they are both on the same horizontal level or same vertical level, then the answer is just absolute difference of A minus C and B minus D. Else, if it is not on the same vertical or horizontal level, like both the vertical and horizontal level are same, not same, they are different, then the answer is just same plus 2. And that's the whole like logic. You can see this by intuition only. I've also worked on a binary series which is like which is located on my channel. You can go and check that out also. I'm also working on backtracking series, so like do subscribe my channel if you haven't, and I'll see you in the next one. Keep coding. Bye.